So, Gop Kumar didn't. The Brahmana wanted Gop Kumar to stay and take his lunch at his house, but Gop Kumar didn't want to see this. I want to see the opulence. I want to see how the Lord is worshipped. So Gop Kumar left, he offered his obeisances to the Brahmana, and then he went, just rushed away. He was so eager to go to the city. He wanted to see this, wanted to see how the Lord of the universe was being worshipped. So he got to the city, and he was asking about the temple where the Lord of the universe was, and when he got near, he could hear all the sounds coming from the temple. They were having arti, and people were blowing conch shells, and there was kirtan, singing. So he could hear the kirtan. It sounded really, it was so exciting. It's so wonderful. He'd never heard like this before. All the singing and dancing, blowing conch shells. And then he came in the temple room and he saw the Lord. He saw it was a form of Lord Vishnu, forearm form. And he saw the Lord holding the four symbols of Lord Vishnu, the disc and the lotus flower and the club. And he was appreciating the beauty of the body of the deity. He saw how the Lord, the form of the deity, is very youthful. He's not an old man. All the parts of all the different body very attractive. And dressed in yellow silk and with different ornaments on his body, and garlands of fragrant flowers. And a beautiful face with lotus eyes. And he saw people on either side fanning him and using the chamara, and they were, at the same time people were coming and offering things to him. And the deity standing, watching, looking. The deity is on a throne, and everyone's dancing in front of him and singing and rejoicing for his pleasure, for the pleasure of the deity. So when Gop Kumar saw this, he oh, this is it. This is what I always wanted to see. Now my life is successful. And he offered his obeisances and fell on the ground. And he got up and he offered obeisances again and again. And he thought, now my life is successful. I will never leave this place. So he had left everything. He left his family and his friends. And somehow he come to this place. He was, you know, he was like a foreigner. But the people were kind to him, would give him the large prasadam. And they would speak kind words to him, and they would encourage him that he saw he's devoted to the deity. So they would encourage him, and they would help him if he needed anything. They would give, they would protect him. And they gave him shelter there. Although it was like the palace, the temple of the king, they allowed him to remain there. And every day he would eat the Mahaprasadam, the remnants from the Mahaprasadam. And every day he would see the festival in the temple, he'd see the programs, and he would hear all the talking and glorification of the Lord. Yeah, they would be reciting the scriptures, so he would hear them speaking about it. And at the same time, he still continued to chant his mantra. Right? He was doing that, you know, he would chant his mantra silently. He would go to a quiet, private place and he would sit down and he would. But while he was staying there, he heard from all the Vaishnavas there, he heard that worship of Vishnu is the highest thing anybody can do. And he also heard about the power of eating Lord Vishnu's prasadam. People told him, the scriptures, it says that if you just, in this Kali Yuga, if you eat some rice, which benefit as somebody who fasts for 6 months. So they told him these kind of things, but they never gave him he didn't get a real systematic spiritual education. Nobody told him about the basic things, the basic knowledge of spiritual education. He didn't know about the existence, how he didn't know how there were planets, like the heavenly planets where Indra, the king of heaven, lives. He didn't know about these things. The devotees never thought to tell him because they didn't know he hadn't had this kind of education. They didn't know Gop Kumar had not had this education, so the devotees did not tell him these basic things. Yeah, Gop Kumar had never had any real training. So he didn't know anything in the material world. He didn't know about the material universe, how there's different levels of planets in the universe. And Gop Kumar, while he was there in this town, serving in this town, eating Mahaprasadam every day, he could never forget how he had been a cowherd boy in Vrindavan, and he would always remember how beautiful and how nice it was in Vrindavan. And he would also remember how happy he was as a cowherd boy. Yeah, he was remembering Vrindavan, and this was because he was chanting his mantra. This was the result of the mantra, because remember his mantra, he was worshipping Madan Gopal, the Lord of Vrindavan. So although he was seeing Lord Vishnu worshipped in great opulence, it didn't give him any more happiness than he got when he was in Vrindavan. And he could not forget Vrindavan. Even when he took part in Lord Vishnu's festivals, when you'd have a big festival in the Vishnu temple, still his mind would often come about Vrindavan. So because he's staying in that temple, this temple of Vishnu, he was staying there for some time. In the course of time, he wanted to take part, to help in the worship. He wanted to do some service. He wanted to to develop some personal relationship with the deity. So it happened that the king of that place, who was a devotee, who was maintaining the deity there, he did not have any son. So the king saw Gop Kumar, and he saw Gop Kumar's good qualities, and he understood he was a foreigner. The king became affectionate to him, and what happened was the king actually adopted Gop Kumar like his son. So after the king, just a little while after the king had adopted Gop Kumar, the king died. And Gop Kumar, because he was like the son of the king, he became the king. Yeah.
So there's echo.
But I incanted to hear clearly what you're saying. Yeah, so Gop Kumar became the king, and when he became the king, then he was happy because he could take charge of the worship of the deity, and he arranged to do the festivals even better, and he had more festivals, and he had made the festivals more opulent.
He
made sure that every day all the different sadhus, the holy men, would be given mahaprasadam from the worship. They would distribute nice prasadam to all the sadhus. He was not affected by the opulence of being the king. He continued to live in the same way, although he was the king. He didn't become proud and he didn't play. Like every day he would eat the remnants, the Mahaprasadam of the deity. He would take the mercy of the deity, and every day he would also chant his mantra. So because he was chanting his mantra, it protected him from becoming contaminated by the power of being the king. People can be very easily affected when they get power or wealth, and it can destroy their good qualities. But Gop Kumar didn't allow that to happen to him. He kept up his sadhana every day, chanting his mantra, and every day just eating the Mahaprasada. And he was not attached to having the power. He divided the power. He divided different responsibilities of being the king. He handed over different responsibilities to the officers there and to the relatives of the dead king. Yeah, because he was careful, because he knew people would criticize him if he spent too much time just private meditation. They would say, oh, he's not responsible, he doesn't take care of the kingdom.
他十分小心，他不喜欢人们批评他，花太多的时间做自己的冥想，不履行国王的职责。
So he gave the he divided responsibilities among some of the different relatives and the different officers there. He made sure he was not the only one to have the responsibility.
他便把国王的权力下分给不同的官员和各亲戚，他确保自己不是唯一一个履行职责的人物。
But still, because he was the king, there were always some politics, and there were some different conflicts, different decisions. There would be arguments, and he would have to get involved in all of these things.
由于他是国王，所以不可避免的要涉及到政治冲突，他必须要做决策，有时候还会有争论，他不可避免的卷入了一些。
And because he's king, he has to worry also about other kings, the neighboring kings, that sometimes they may threaten.
因为他是国王，所以他有时候要担心国王威胁到他的统治。
And above the king, there's an emperor, the emperor who's above all the kings, and sometimes the emperor would give orders, and he would have to take, he'd have to do things, he'd have to make consideration to follow the orders of the emperor.
在他上面还有皇帝的就会对下面的各个国王发号施令，所以他不得不要考虑皇帝的命令。
So Gob Kumar had he was seeing being the king was not very nice. There was a lot of anxiety there, which was disturbing his meditation and his spiritual practice.
Gopal Kumar 觉得当国王不是很好的事情，因为要各种焦虑，就打扰了他的冥想和灵性休息。
So there were material problems. The brahmanas there in the temple who were they had some rules, they had some regulations that they didn't want to take the remnant, they didn't want to take prasadam if it had been touched by anybody outside the temple.
除了这些物质问题之外，还有庙里出现的问题。庙里的 brahman 呢，他们有一些规则，这些 brahman 呢不想触碰就被庙外面的人触碰过的 prasadam。
Yeah, they thought if somebody's from outside the temple, they cannot be pure. And if they touch the prasadam, then the prasadam must be contaminated.
他们这些婆罗门人都是不纯洁的，如果触碰了 Mahaprasadam 就被污染。
And they would not take anything, they would not take prasadam outside the temple. It had to be eaten in the temple.
他们不吃庙外面的任何 prasadam, 他们只吃庙里的 prasadam.
And then there would often be some argument about if the prasadam is actually pure or not.
持续不断的就有这种争论，到底普沙等是不是纯洁的。
So this kind of arguments, this the brahmanas, you know, the brahmanas who are doing in the temple, who are very senior, they would be very critical sometimes.
这样的争论给古巴库马尔就带来了焦虑，因为庙里的 brahmana 都很年长，对事物很挑剔。
They were very strict about what they would accept. They would only take the prasadam of Lord Vishnu.
他们对于吃什么样的食物很严格，他们吃 Vishnu 的 prasadam.
And if it had been touched by anybody who is servants of the deity, then they wouldn't take it.
假设这样的 prasadam 被 不是神像的仆人，除了神像的仆人之外的别人所触碰，他们就再也不会荣耀这样的 prasadam。
And they wouldn't take anything outside the area of the temple。
他们也从来不吃庙宇区域之外的任何的食物。
And they said, this is a tradition here. We always do like this. This has been the tradition.
他们说这就是这里的传统，就是历来我们一直在这样做。
So this is not the real understanding about prasada. And who's actually the devotee, he won't be happy to hear this kind of thing.
这并不是对于 prasada 的正确理解，一位奉献者他听到这样的话不会高兴。
Because devotees, we understand that prasadam, the remnants of Lord Krishna, it can be eaten by anyone.
主的奉献者理解 Krishna 的 prasada 任何人都可以吃。
And it can never be contaminated by anybody, even somebody is of a very low birth or impure, but they cannot contaminate prasadam.
主的 Krishna 的 prasadam 不会受到污染，即便是一个出生低贱的甚至不纯洁的人也不会污染。
Because prasadam is none different from Lord Vishnu himself. It's the same as Vishnu is and his mercy. They're not different. Lord Vishnu cannot be contaminated.
Prasadam 就像 Vishnu 本人， Vishnu 和 Vishnu 的仁慈是永远不会受到污染的。
And if we think prasadam can be contaminated, you get a reaction for that. The reaction is that you will suffer leprosy, and you will lose your children, and you will lose your wife, and you'll go to hell and never return.
这样的想法会有反应，这样的报应就是说，他会得天花、麻风病，他失去自己的妻子、儿子，他会去地狱，永远回不来。
So Gop Kumar was in. He was not happy. He had these problems. Although he was a king, but he saw the difficulty dealing with these brahmanas. It was very made him very unhappy.
Gopakumar 内心闷闷不乐，因为他要面对这样的问题，这样的困难，还要面对这样的这些 Brahmana。
But at the same time, he was attached to the deity and doing service to the deity, and that was very pleasing to him. He liked that. He just didn't like being surrounded by all of these Brahmana people.
非常依附神像，他喜欢神像，可是他要四周围都是这些 Brahmana， 这令他不快。
So the contact with the Brahmanas and hearing the criticism of the Brahmanas made it very difficult for him to continue.
You mean hear criticism from other people of the Brahmana?
No, just hear the Brahmanas, how they would criticize, how they would complain about the prasadam, and that would not follow, the people are not following properly.
Okay. Gopakumar, 跟这些 Brahmana 的接触，听到 Brahmana 的批评之声，抱怨之词，令他内心闷闷不乐。
So, it was at this time that some other Vaishnavas came, and they were coming from Jagannath Puri, and they came to visit this temple where Gop Kumar was staying. These were coming from Jagannath Puri, and they were just wanting to see the different deities, to visit different temples, and they came there to where Gop Kumar was.
在这个时候， 有来自加拿大的 Puri 的奉献者，这些奉献者就来到 Gopal Kumar 待的庙宇。这些奉献者们会四处漫游，拜访不同的庙宇。
So Gopal Kumar, he had never heard about Jagannath Puri. He didn't know anything about it. So they were telling him about Jagannath Puri, how it's on the coast beside the sea, and there's a big mountain, a blue mountain, beside that place, and there the Lord of the Universe is there, and the Lord of the Universe is there in the form of in a wooden form.
Jagannath Puri 的这些奉献者就给他描述，说 Jagannath Puri 坐落于海边，旁边是一座蓝色的山，宇宙之主就住在那里，他是以木质的形体居住在那里。
Right, and this Lord of the Universe is in the holy dam. The holy dam there is called Purushottama. Purushottam Kshetra. Kshetra means the field or the place. So it's the place of Purushottam, the place of the Supreme Person. This holy place, its name is
Purushottama Kshetra.Chitra 的意思是地方，这个地方是普如舍瓦。
And because he's in the wooden form, the wood is called Daru. So he is called Daru Brahman, meaning the Lord has a, he's spiritual, but he's in the form, in a wooden form.
形体它是木质的，因此被称为 Daru Brahman， 意思是说主是灵性的，但是它有一个木质的身体。
So it is that this Purushottam Kshetra, the Lord of the Universe resides there on the shore of the ocean, and he is in great ecstasy, and he has this wooden form.
因此，主就居住在 Purushottama Kshetra， 在海岸边，他是狂喜的形象，他以木头的形象显现在那里。
And he is known by the name Jagannath, and he rules the kingdom. He rules this kingdom with great opulence. He has great opulence also, and he has wonderful qualities. Most important is he takes care.Of his devotees.
他的名字叫 Jagannath. 他统治着这片王国。他拥有着巨大的富裕和美好的品质。他的最美妙的一个品质是他会照料他的奉献者。
Yeah, he gives Lord Jagannath as a deity gives instructions and tells the people.How they should do the business and what their personal affairs should be. He guides them in many ways.
神像他还会给人们以叙事，该怎样做生意，该怎样来处理他们的私人事务，一个个方面的在照料着他们的生活。
He's very kind and compassionate on unfortunate souls.And he's very affectionate to the people who are his servants.
他对于不幸的、受条件限制的灵魂是慈爱有加，内心怀着巨大的怜悯。同时，他对于他的仆人们非常的亲切。
He does not take their offenses very seriously.
He's. 他
Yeah, go ahead.
对于这些。冒犯他并不看得很严重。
To him is cooked by his consort Lakshmi, and after the Lord takes the food offered to him by Lakshmi, he distributes his remnants to his beasts.
他所吃的食物是由他的伴侣 Lakshmi 亲手所做，在吃完之后，他会把
That's very rare to get the remnants of Lord Vishnu. Even the demigods, they hardly ever get that. But in Purukshottam Kshetra, people can get very easily. Lord Jagannath makes sure that all his devotees get his prasada. When everything is cooked, the Lord is offered, and the food is offered in clay pots, and sometimes he will eat a portion, and sometimes he'll eat everything. But after he eats it, then the pot will fill up again.
并且供奉给主之后，这些菩萨的都是由马罐所做。主扎格纳特有时候吃一部分，有时候都全部吃光。但是每次这个罐子当中又装满了菩萨的。So
these Vaishnavas, they're telling Gop Kumar, they told him that that food, that is Lord Jagannath's Mahaprasad. And it doesn't matter if it's touched by anyone or if it's from far away, the devotee will immediately eat it. Because the Mahaprasadam of Lord Jagannath has already been touched by the lips of Lord Jagannath, so it can never be contaminated. Even if you may take the food to put in some unclean place, or you may give it to some low-class person, but it can never be contaminated.
即便这样的食物拿到了不洁之地，或者是给予了低阶层的人们，这样的食物也永远不会受到污染。And
no good person would ever refuse to eat Lord Jagannath's Mahaprasadam.
没有任何善良的人会拒绝吃扎格纳德的Mahaprasadam.
Nobody will ever complain, though. Oh, it's not. It may not be pure. Or now is not the proper time. Nobody will say that. There's a pastime in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Lord Chaitanya was bringing prasadam to give to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, who was a big high-class brahmana.
有一个小时光，在《Chaitanya Charitamrita》这部书当中，主Chaitanya他给把主Jagannath的Mahaprasadam带给了一个高等的Brahmana Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya。So
it was early in the morning. Bhattacharya had just got up from bed, and Lord Chaitanya came knocking on the door and said, "I brought you some Mahaprasadam."
这时候还是一大早，主Chaitanya，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya在床上，外面传来了主Chaitanya的敲门声，他告诉他，我给你带来了Jagannath的Mahaprasada。So
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya got up from the bed, and even though he hadn't taken bath, he hadn't washed his mouth, he immediately ate the prasadam. And Lord Chaitanya was very pleased.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就立刻从床上起身，虽然他还没有沐浴，也没有漱口，但是却立刻吃掉了Mahaprasadam。主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu内心非常的高兴。And
Lord Chaitanya said, "Yes, this is proper. When we are given Mahaprasadam, we should immediately accept it."
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，对，就应该这样。无论什么时候我们被给予了Mahaprasadam，我们就应该立刻的荣耀掉。
So if we take prasadam in the proper spirit, then it will help us to get rid of all of our sins.
如果我们以正确的精神来吃不杀的，就能去除掉所有的罪恶。
But if we think, oh, it's become dry, oh, it's been there for a long time, if we think materially, then that will not be good.
但如果我们想，哦，它已经干了，哦，它放的时间太长了，如果有这样的物质念头，并不好。
So we should never think about prasadam in any material way.
我们不应该以物质的方式来考虑 prasadam.
There's no restrictions about when to take prasadam. It's not like, you know, when you make some vow, you do chaturmasya or something.
对于普沙的荣耀普沙的时间没有任何限制，并不像我们发下了查托玛夏的誓言。
So then the Vaishnavas, they're telling Gop Kumar about Jagannath Puri. They told them, they said, all the residents in Jagannath Puri have got four arms. Even the donkeys living there have four arms.
Vaishnava 们就告诉 Gopal Kumar, Jagannath Puri, 那里呢居民们都有四臂，连那里的驴子也有四臂。
Anybody who enters that place, the district of Jagannath Puri, they will never have to take birth again.
任何进入到 Jagannath Puri 这一区域的人永远不用再次投生。
This way Gop Kumar is being convinced about what a wonderful place this Jagannath Puri is, how it's a very holy abode.
就这样呢 Gopal Kumar 确信 Jagannath Puri 是一处美丽的神圣之地。
Even the demigods in heaven, they can see that all the residents there in Jagannath Puri have got four arms.
天堂的半神人也看到扎格纳普瑞的居民们都长着四臂。
And anybody who comes there, they can get freed from their sins. And they won't have to take another birth.
任何去那里的人都摆脱了罪恶，再不用投生。
Even if somebody is sinful for many lives,But if they come in contact with this holy place, then they can get freed from their sins. They can be liberated to the spiritual world.
即便是罪恶的人，累世犯下了罪恶的人，接触了这样的圣地，圣地，他们的罪恶也能洗清，获得解脱。进入灵性世界。
And if you're able to see the deity there, the personality in the deity form, if you can see Lord Jagannath in his deity form, then your life is successful.
如果能见到那里的神像 Jagannath, 生命就能达到成功。
So the beauty of Lord Jagannath is very special. His beautiful lotus eyes, his compassionate glance. People see Lord Jagannath and their lives can be changed. Their whole life can be changed.
就 Jagannath 的美丽是无与伦比的，很特殊。他的莲花眼，他的怜悯的瞥视。任何人见到了主，他的生活就彻底的改变了。
So Gop Kumar is hearing about all of, he's hearing about Lord Jagannath and about the Purushottam Kshetra, the place of. So naturally, he's very attracted and he thinks about it.
Gop Kumar 聆听了主 Jagannath 和 Purushottam Kshetra 的荣耀。内心自然而然的就受到吸引了。
Alright. of course, Gop Kumar, he was worshipping Lord Vishnu there. So Lord Vishnu, he is like, he's not the original personality of Godhead. Lord Vishnu is one of the avatars of the Supreme Lord. Lord Jagannath, Supreme Personality of Godhead, he's the original, and all the other incarnations of him.
Gopa Kumar 崇拜着 Vishnu, 而是至尊主的化身 Avatar, 而主扎格纳的是原始的神手，他是所有化身的源泉。So
seeing the Lord in his incarnation is good, but it's better if you can see the original Supreme Lord, Lord Jagannath.
见到主的化身当然很好，更好的就是见到至尊主，原始的至尊主，Jagannath.
So Gop Kumar, he'd never heard like this before, and he was not too much attached to worshipping the Lord's deity, and that was because of the mercy of the mantra which he'd been given by his spiritual master. The spirit, his spiritual master and Krishna are guiding Gop Kumar so that he will go step by step, that gradually he's going to come to understand the nature of the Lord and the spiritual world. Everything will be revealed gradually, not immediate, not all at one time.
灵性导师和Krishna在指导着Gopa Kumar，一步一步的逐渐理解主以及灵性世界的本质。灵性世界的本质，他会逐步的揭示给Gopa Kumar，而不是立刻的揭示给他。
So he has this, he's heard about Lord Jagannath, so he has a desire to go there and see Lord Jagannath.
Gopa Kumar 听说了Jagannath，就内心萌生了想要见主Jagannath的愿望。
So even though he'd become the king there in that place, he just immediately left everything and went off going to Jagannath Puri. And he's chanting Lord Jagannath's glories as he goes.
Gopa Kumar 虽放弃了一切，动身离开了那个地方，去唱着扎格纳的荣耀，前往扎格纳的普瑞。
So we will hear what happens when he gets to Jagannath Puri in the next class.
我们将在下一堂课来听普瑞发生的事情。
Okay, so any questions today?
Yes.
Okay. Questions?
Questions. Just wait a minute, I'll search for the questions.
Okay.
Hare Krishna, 对今天的问题有点多，没查到第一个问题是吗？我这个电脑现在，看看，我帮你念吗？
可以。
的问题，感谢 Maharaja，感谢翻译，Gopa Kumar 变得不嫉妒。 请问嫉妒的表现形式是什么？不嫉妒的表现形式又是什么？谢谢。
What is the characteristic of one who's envious, and what is the characteristic of one who's not envious?
Yes, Mara. Symptom. What's the symptom?
Oh, the symptom. Okay.
Yes.
Well, if we're not envious of, if we're envious of someone, then we will do everything we can to complain about them. We won't see good in them. We'll criticize them unnecessarily.
如果我们嫉妒一个人，就会不停地抱怨这个人，看不到这个人身上的优点，只是毫无必要地在抱怨他，批评他。
So the converse is true. If one is not envious, then we will see the good. We will see good in people. We will appreciate them.
反之，我们若不嫉妒一个人，就会看到对方的好处、优点，欣赏他。
So being giving up envy is a very important quality. Lord Krishna describes in Bhagavad Gita that because Arjuna is not envious, therefore Lord Krishna is speaking this knowledge to him.
放弃嫉妒是非常重要的品质，在博迦梵歌当中，主 Krishna 因为 Arjuna 毫无嫉妒之心，因此主向 Arjuna 讲述了博迦梵歌。
In the material world, there's so much envy between people who spend so much time trying to criticize others and find fault unnecessarily in others.
在物质世界，嫉妒比比皆是，人们就没有必要的在批评别人，挑剔别人。
So it's very important that we don't fall into that kind of trap. We don't want to develop that kind of habit.
重要的是，我们不要堕入到这样的一个轨道当中，不要养成这样的习性。
And the way to it is by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra more, by keeping the holy name on our tongue, constant chanting of the holy name.
避免这样的品质是通过不断的、恒常的唱诵 Hare Krishna, 把圣名放在舌尖。
And so when Lord Chaitanya was instructing Raghunath Das Goswami, Raghunath Das had renounced, he'd left everything to come to Jagannath Puri to reside there. Lord Chaitanya told him, don't hear the talks of the ordinary people and don't speak like them.
主陈哈布就训示 Raghunath Das Goswami, 他弃绝了家庭来到 Jagannath Puri, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就教导他听普通人的讲话，不要像普通人那样去说话。
Yeah, he encouraged Raghunath Das, offer all respects to others and do not be eager to be respected yourself. Constantly chant the holy name.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 鼓励 Raghunath Das Goswami 要向众人致以尊敬，不渴望别人的尊敬，要恒常唱诵圣名。
So we can give up envy by appreciating others.
我们通过欣赏别人放弃嫉妒之心。
Okay, another question.
Sati Madhatikan, 你能读一下吗？我这那 okay. Just a minute, Mar, I will search for the question.
好的，我读一下啊。第二个问题还是染着帕布的，有关菩萨达的。菩萨达是纯洁的，是否制作菩萨达的人的知觉不同，菩萨达的纯净度也有所不同。
You go to mine.
The question is that prasadam is pure, although prasadam is pure, but according to the person who cooked the prasadam, according to the purity, so the level of purity of prasadam will vary due to the cooker whose consciousness is pure, the level of the pure of the cooker, cooks.
Well, we have to understand that in a temple, the cooks are supposed to be qualified. And the qualification is generally to cook on a fire, to cook on a flame, one should be twice initiated. Within ISKCON, we have a standard that people who are cooking and who are worshipping the deity, they have to be following strictly four regulative principles and chanting 16 rounds.
在 ISKCON 当中，它标准就是 ，prasad 呢，要遵守规范原则，每天念诵十六圈。
It's not good.
如果你在烹饪 prasad 的同时呢，并不按照这样的标准，这就是一种欺骗。
So, we should have faith in the standard that the people cooking are responsible devotees. They're honest. They're not cheaters.
我们要有信心，做 prasad 的人呢，应该是负责任的人，诚实的人，不欺骗的人。
And we should have faith that the prasadam is pure.
我们要坚信 prasadam 是纯粹纯洁的。
You don't want to be discriminating, but using your material judgment, who is a good devotee, who is not a good devotee. We should consider what is my position. If I'm in that consciousness thinking, oh, this person's not a good devotee, I don't trust their cooking, that's material. So we look at our own faults. It's not good for us to try to judge others. Another question.
好的，下一个。菩萨的是纯净的，是否意味着我们可以吃任何人的妈哈？
我们可以吃人 ，we can eat other people's maha.
Yeah.
Well, we're supposed to eat the remnants of Lord Krishna.
我们理应吃主 Krishna 的寄语。
And we're allowed also. We may be allowed. We may be given the remnants of the spiritual master.
我们也被允许来吃灵性导师的。
But to take someone else's remnants, first of all, that person, you should not take it without permission. Is he giving you permission to eat his remnants?
至于别人的菩萨的，首先要得到别人的允许。他是不是，别人是不是允许你吃他的菩萨的？
Now, most people are not going to give you their remnants because they know if they give you the remnants, they're going to take your karma.
大部分人是不会允许把自己的 prasadam 给你的，因为如果他你吃了他们的 prasadam， 他 们就要承担你的 karma。
The spiritual master will give the remnants to his disciples because he's taking their karma anyway.
灵性导师会把他的 prasadam 给予你，因为灵性导师无论如何是要承担你的业报。
So generally, when the spiritual master's prasadam is distributed, should only be given to his initiated disciples.
一般情况下派发灵性导师的 prasadam 只能派给他启迪的门徒。
Okay.
Okay. 下一个是仆人问的问题：承担族长或者是庙长的职责的时候，当要处理一些事情的时候，确实会打扰念诵圣名。如何保持不被打扰，同时又履行自己的职责？
You go ahead.
Yes. The questions that as a group leader or temple president, they have to deal with the practical situation, but this will disturb their chanting holy names.How can I carry out my duties at the same time not disturbed by these practical affairs?
Yes, just like we saw Gop Kumar was a king and he saw he got disturbed, his sadhana got disturbed by all the responsibilities he had.
我们看到就像 Gop Kumar 他当了国王，他的 sadhana 就受到了打扰。
So when you take some responsibility in management or for others, you have to expect that's going to happen sometimes.
一旦你承担了管理职责，就要指望着这种事情会发生的。
So you have to make arrangements so that you can do your sadhana early enough so that you don't get...You won't get disturbed with all of these things.
所以你就要安排很早的就要做好你的 sadhana， 这样呢就不会受到这些事情的干扰。
But you take some responsibility. You have to expect people are sometimes going to come and disturb you. You can have also office hours. You can have particular times when they come and see you.You can restrict your time for dealing with these affairs.
如果你会有这些事情会打扰你，但是你可以制定办公时间，只在这个时间段内处理这些事情，限制这个时间，这样在这样的特定时间内处理这些事物。
All managers, people with responsibilities, they all face this problem. So you have to organize your time properly.
所有的管理者都面临这种问题，因此你要恰如其分地管理好，组织好自己的时间。
You may have family responsibilities, you have to give time for that.
你还有自己的家庭职责，你也要给这个家庭职责，安排好时间。
And you may have work to do. You may have a job. You may be employed. You have to give time for that.
你可能有工作，你是一个工作。
And you have to also give time for your sadhana.
你也要花出时间来做好自己的 sadhana.
And you're taking responsibility for devotees, so you have to make arrangements. You have to have time when you can actually deal with their problems, with their issues.
你现在承担了职责来管理奉献者们，对此你也要花时间来正确的处理。
So let them know when is the proper time to approach you.
因此呢，你就要让奉献者知道他们什么时间找你是最合适的。
Yeah. Okay. 下一个问题。Sati.
下一
个。嗯。
Parable. Okay.我麦有点不太好用。下一个问题是啊，任正帕布 ，Gopal Kumar 身为一代君王，有那么多职责要履行，操心事情如此之多。同样，如果管理事务过多，是否会影响到灵修？因为上一个问题好像您已经都回答过了。
对，都回答。嗯，下一个问题。
好的，下一个问题，大。是不是做 Prasada 的奉献者的品质，无论是好坏，都会影响到荣耀 Prasada 的人？好像前面 也有回答。
If the Prasada is good or bad, it's going to. What effect is it going to have on the devotee?
The question is that the quality of the prasadam will anyway influence the quality of devotee who honor the prasadam. Is the question?
Yes.
Is that
definitely?
是的，毫无疑问，确定无疑。
When we have first class prasadam, then it will help also the devotees to develop more bhakti, more devotion.
我们如果是一流的 prasadam 会帮助荣耀这样 prasadam 人发展起 bhakti、
so, we want to have the first class prasadam means first class cooks, first class brahmanas to offer, and devotees should also take the prasadam in good consciousness, not in material consciousness. They shouldn't eat the prasadam just to satisfy their tongue.
我们要有一流的厨师，一流的 brahmana 来供奉，同时，荣耀 prasadam 的奉献者，他们也要端正自己。
You should want to taste Krishna when we are honoring. We honor prasadam. We don't just simply eat prasadam. We honor it. So take the prasadam with the right mood, with the mood of devotion.
我们不是，我们荣耀 prasadam 不是为了满足自己的舌头，我们从荣耀的，我们在品味着 Krishna， 我们是荣耀 prasadam， 同时呢，我们也要赞扬 prasadam 的品质。
OK， 下一个问题，咋地？
下一个问题，同样是 Das 问的。prasadam 是超然的，那么如果奉献者在荣耀的过程中。触碰过菩萨的也是可以荣耀的嘛，也就是说这个奉献者触碰过的这个菩萨的别人还可以再荣耀吗？应该怎么处理？
His question is that if a prasadam is transcendental, but if devotees has touched prasadam, can this kind of prasadam distributed to others?
Yes.
是的。
If the devotees touched the prasadam, but if they may have touched it like when they're serving it, but do you mean they've eaten from it? If they've eaten from it,The devotees should eat what's on their own plate. They don't let it be taken to be given to others.
Oh, 如果是派 prasadam 的人，他触碰了这个 prasadam， 这是一回事儿。如果是奉献者已经自己吃过了 prasadam， 这样触碰过的，那么奉献者应该把自己盘子当中的 prasadam 吃光。
We don't want to give our karma to other people. Oh, we don't want to take other people's karma. If they eat your remnants, then you take their karma.
我们不想接受别人的 karma。如果有人别的人吃了你的prasadam，那你就要承担那个人的 karma。
Next， 下一个问题 ，Chaitanya Charanprabhu 的，菩萨呢是超然的，永远不会被污染，但人还没有成为纯粹的奉献者，应该是被污染的。我们吃了受污染的人碰过的菩萨的，我们是否被污染，沾染上他的业报？这个好像你也都已经回答过了之前。
OK。下一个问题。
下一个问题，萨提，顶拜咕噜莲花族，请问就是庙宇里的那些婆罗门，非常严格苛刻的遵守他们的这个规范原则，那么对于其他奉献者的服务挑剔指责，这些婆罗门，他们都是非常年长的资深的这些奉献者。为什么他们还没有这个包容和欣赏之心呢？他们是嫉妒吗？
Go ahead, Guru Mani.
Okay, the Brahmana who very strictly follow all the regular principles, they criticize and find fault with others. So although they are very senior, so they lack the mood of toleration and appreciation. So is that the kind of enviness?
Yes, you could say like that. Somehow they've been brought up in that culture and they've developed that habit to look down on others.
是的，可以这样说，他们是在这样的文化。
Sometimes people have that mentality. They're thinking they're better than others.
所以他们就瞧不起别人，觉得自己别人要高人一等。
So very important to develop humility and to offer respect to others.
所以培养谦卑是非常重要的，要尊重别人。
The more we advance, the more we should become humble and consider ourselves fallen.
我们自己越进步，就会越谦卑，觉得自己很堕落。
还有问题吗？
有的，古德，今天问题很多。Samasaki。Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru Day， 顶拜翻译，请问 Guru Day， 到过加格纳特普瑞的人就不会再在这个世界降生，可有的人去了，回来之后又继续做违反四项规范原则的活动，这样的人会得到主加格纳特的仁慈吗？再次顶拜 Guru Day。想念你。
So somebody went to Jagannath Puri and then they come back and then they do sinful activities, they don't do good. So will they still get the mercy of Lord Jagannath? Is it like
yes,
that?
Yes, they broken the four regulative principles. Will they still get the mercy of Jagannath?
Of course. If they do bad, if they do sinful activities, then they're not going to get the full mercy of Jagannath. You cannot expect that you can cheat Jagannath. Lord Jagannath gives some mercy, we should take advantage of the mercy. We should go on. But if we do, again, go back to material life, then it's like building a fire and then throwing water on the fire. And so the benefit of going to Jagannath Puri will be greatly reduced by our sinful activities.
我们得到了主加格纳的仁慈，就要好好的善加利用，继续的进步。但是如果回来又从事着物质的罪恶活动，这就好像一边在这里点着火，一边又往上面浇水，这样的，主扎甘纳特的，这种好处就大大的减少了。
Okay, any other question?
是的，下一个是一位新人问的，顶拜古鲁，请问在灵性世界吃什么？
In the spiritual world, we will eat spiritual food, Krishna prasada. It's all prasada in the spiritual world.
在灵性世界，我们吃的是 Krishna 的 prasada， 吃的是灵性的 prasada。
Prabhupada said, in Vrindavan, everything is prasada. So in the spiritual world, everything is prasada.
Prabhupada 说过，在 Vrindavan 一切都是 prasada， 因此在灵性世界一切都是 prasada。
下一个问题。
下一个问题，杨改莲马大吉，顶拜 Guru Day， 顶拜翻译，在这个卡利年代是如此的愚昧，到圣地去见加格纳的神像，会不会有冒犯呢？会产生哪些后果呢？好的还是不好的结果？
Okay.
The question is that in the Kali Yuga, everything is in ignorance. If we go to Jagannath Puri to see Darshan the Lord, will we offend the Lord? What kind of result will be to go to Jagannath Puri?And what's the benefit and the negative thing of doing that?
Well, offenses will take away your interest in devotional service. You'll have less and less interest and you'll start to find fault with devotees and complain and have many problems.And then you have less and less interest in devotional service. That's the result of offenses.
冒犯的这个后果就是对奉献服务的兴趣越来越少，开始挑剔奉献者，抱怨奉献者，会看到问题，这样的结果就是兴趣越来越少了。
Therefore, when you go to holy places, you have to go in the association of a senior devotee who can guide you and protect you from being offensive.
因此去圣地，护你，可以指导你免于冒犯。
You do not get reactions for offenses in the mind. You have to actually commit the offense before you get.
在心意里的这个冒犯是得不会有任何的业报反应，必须得真正的从事了这些冒犯。
Okay, 下一个问题。
好，下一个问题 ，Radha Ananda， Hare Krishna， 深深顶拜敬爱的 Maharaja， 请问心意不安不稳的人供奉的 Boga 主 Vishnu 会接受吗？感谢翻译。
If our mind is not steady, will Lord Krishna or Lord Vishnu accept our offering?
Yes.
Uh-huh. So, the mind is not steady. Yeah, Lord Krishna can accept the offering.We may do it, our mind may not be steady, but you do the offering, Lord Krishna he may accept it. We hope he certainly should accept it. But we should try to make the mind steady. So before you do the offering, you're supposed to, you should, you know, you do akshman, and then you have to We have to try to correct that mentality. If we know the mind is not steady, you have to make the mind steady. You have to try to do the offering, the proper mood. But important thing is to do the offering. And gradually, mind will become steady. If you're not able to do the offering, steady mind, then you ask someone else to do the offering for you.
Somebody
may be busy in the kitchen and always thinking what's cooking in the kitchen. They're making the offering. They haven't fully finished cooking everything, but they do the offering. And so the mind is not so steady, ask someone else to make the offering.
那么在厨房里做饭的，菩萨的那奉献者呢，他可能非常忙着，脑子里呢全部想的就是在厨房里的那些事情。所以这时候他在做供奉的时候呢，可能脑子里就不是很专注。在这种情况下，他可以请求别人，来代替他来供奉这样的人。When
we make the offering, the mood should be that, dear Lord Krishna, the food is now ready. Please come and take your food.
供奉的时候应该这样祈求，亲爱的主Krishna，现在食物好了，请来吃吧。Okay,
下一个问题，云云，应该是Harivansa发布的。当孩子出生几个月之后，需要照顾孩子和妻子，念诵被打扰，无法完成每天的规范休息，怎么办？
No, we should. Oh, he has a child and he has difficulty to get up and do the chanting, and he has to take care of the child and take care of his wife, so it's disturbing his sadhana. What to do? So, huh? Okay, Guru Man.
So, 是不是这份奉献者他现在有孩子了，他需要很早就起来。 因为他要照顾孩子妻子，所以他的sadhana受影响了呢。对，是的，是的。
So, yeah, be like that. You have to be determined. We know it's not easy to have a child, but you shouldn't allow it to stay like that forever.
你要有下定决心，这种情况肯定是不容易的，但是你不能允许永远都这样子持续下去。
Don't just use it as an excuse, oh, I have a child, I have a wife, so I cannot do sadhana. You have to be more determined, make more effort to do your sadhana. You have to become more serious, more determined. Krishna's given you a child, he's given you a wife. Now you have to, if you want to keep them, you have to keep yourself in Krishna consciousness. Don't just use them as an excuse not to do sadhana.
Yeah.
下一个问题。
Rajendra Prabhu. 圣帕帕德，被，宗生会员邀请去家里荣耀菩萨的，帕帕德去了，他没有吃，他的门徒吃了都坏肚子，是否不是所有的菩萨的都能吃，都要吃？
Well, Srila Prabhupada was invited by the life members to honor prasadam. Srila Prabhupada didn't take the prasadam, but his disciples take. Well, after that, they felt very uncomfortable in their stomach. So in that case, we shouldn't take all the prasadam.
Well, if the spiritual master orders you to take, you have to take.
如果灵性导师命令你来荣耀，你必须要荣耀。
But you don't need to take a lot, you can take a small quantity.
但是你不需要荣耀很大量的，你只需要荣耀一小量、少量的。
Prasadam is offered, it's our duty to accept it. But you don't have to accept a huge amount, just take a small portion.
菩萨的已经供奉过了，我们有职责来荣耀他，但是你不需要荣耀大量的，你只需要荣耀少量的。
You get the bad stomach because you eat too much.
你胃坏了，肚子坏了，是因为吃太多。
下一个问题。
下一个问题，Yogi Mata Mataji，深深的顶拜，亲爱的 Guru Dev，顶拜翻译主持人，请问 Guru Dev，刚才您说不要嫉妒，要去欣赏别人，现在人都充满了嫉妒心，当然也包括我自己。如果你比他弱时，他可以帮助你；一旦发现你比他优秀时，嫉妒心就升起来了。请问 Guru 具体做些什么能够消除嫉妒心呢？是规范修行吗？或者 Guru Day 是否还可以多说点儿？深深的顶拜你。
She wants to know about how to curb envy from coming up. That she tries to stop it, but then it comes back. So how can she get rid of it forever? Is it just by sadhana?
Satimurti，我有点不明白，他说的是别人还是自己？
他就是说这种现象，他说自己也是这种情况，然后就是说他问如何，具体的就是怎么做能够消除这个嫉妒心，是通过规范修行吗？还是其他的？
The sadhana is the solution to all the problems. All the problems which we have, like envy, things which bad impurities in the heart, that can all be removed by Krishna consciousness.
Sadhana 规范修行是一切问题的解决方案，包括内心的不洁都可以被清除，通过 Krishna 知觉。
So practicing Krishna conscious, when we say being Krishna conscious or practicing Krishna consciousness, yes, we're talking about sadhana, means doing more hearing and chanting, doing more service.
修习 Krishna 知觉就包括了 sadhana，聆听、唱诵、做服务。
And we can pray also, offering prayers to the spiritual teachers. That can be also very powerful. That we have a particular desire to get rid of some, that we pray to some of the great personalities in our tradition, and they can help us.
我们可以向灵性老师们供奉祷文。如果我们内心有这样的愿望，我们可以向那些伟大的人物，我们先前传习当中的伟大人物们祈祷。
We need the mercy. We need mercy, so pray for the mercy. You can pray for the mercy and we do We have to just keep the desire, the constant desire. It's going to take some time, but it's possible.
就需要仁慈，我们可以祈祷仁慈，因为我们有这样的愿望，我们内心就要一直的保持着这份愿望，但是这需要时间来实现。
We've spent many lifetimes cultivating envy. We've practiced being envious for many, many lifetimes, many different bodies. It's not so easy to get rid of it immediately.
我们已经生生世世的在练习着培养嫉妒了，在不同的躯体当中，因此要消除嫉妒不容易。
还有问题吗？
是的 ，Good day。还有下面，乐逍遥顶拜咕噜翻译。对于一个新学习 Krishna 知觉的人来说，看书是要循序渐进的吗？他可以看《财坛尼亚经》吗
？A new devotee, can they read the Chaitanya Charitamrita if they're just a new devotee? Well.Prabhupada was reading Chaitanya Charitamrita in the very beginning of our movement. When he went to New York, he would give lectures on Chaitanya Charitamrita. They can, but they should be encouraged also to go back and to read the basic book like Bhagavad Gita, get the foundation right.
在您开始的时候，您运动一开始的时候，圣帕帕德在纽约，他就在庙里讲课的时候也讲 Charitamrita， 所以您是可以看的，但是呢，也要回到最刚开始的博伽梵歌，也要看博伽梵歌，这样可以打下坚实的基础。
But we won't tell them it's wrong. Somebody has an attraction to read Chaitanya Charitamrita. Let them read it. Okay.
但是我们不能说他看这个书是错误的，他是可以看的。
If they read it carefully, then they want to read the Bhagavad Gita.
如果他看这本书特别小心的话，他回头就很想看《巴巴》。
下一个问题。
下一个问题，黑马拉塔，就是我们应该吃的食物不能供奉子，可以吗？
Can we eat food? We should eat food which is offered, but something which has got yeast in it, can we offer? Can we? It's not usually offered, so can we still take it?
Yes.
Well, if you've cooked something with yeast, then whatever you eat, you have to offer it. Even though it's got yeast in, you have to offer. We wouldn't offer it in the temple. We wouldn't offer it on the altar in the temple. But you may offer it in your home. If you're using that thing at home, then you should offer whatever you eat, even if you've put yeast in it.Of course, best is not to put yeast.
我们无论吃什么都不需要先供奉。我们不需要，我们不需要去庙里头到神坛上去供奉。但是在家中，我们在家中呢，如果我们用这个酵母来做的食物，那么也要供奉。当然，最好的就是不用酵母。
Yeah, find some substitutes instead of putting yeast. The yeast is not so healthy.
We can find some 酵母的替代品，因为这个发酵的酵母它不是很有利于健康。
下一个问题。
下一个问题 ，Hari Priya Radhika Madaji， 顶拜咕噜。当发现有人要求你想学习奉爱经典内容时，要求你先保证承诺承担去传教， 还推荐允许你报名学习。如果你对未来说不确定有这样的能力，对方就说那主的奉献者不培养这样不作为的人，因为你没有奉献服务的精神，你不能租房，又不能出去，又不能出钱出力。说学习奉爱服务是70%人搞人际关系，70%搞人际关系，30%才是经典知识。请问如何和这样的奉献者相处？
I haven't got it.
就是他这奉献者要求他去学经典，或者是他想去学经典的时候，推荐他的时候就必须让他保证你学习之后要去传教，你不传教，然后就说他你没有这样的能力，我们就不推荐你去学。然后他就说你如果没有奉献精神，你又不能出钱也不能出力，就是我没有必要培养你。然后说做奉献服务是70%要这个和奉献者相处，处理这个人际关系问题，30%才是学经典。就是他问如何和这样的奉献者相处。
Can you translate something for Guruman?
Yes, it's, well, this devotee, she wants to learn something like Bhakti Satra, in my understanding. But the person, another devotee, maybe the leader or the teacher.
They won't recommend her.
They first ask this devotee to make a vow to be a preacher in the future, because this course is
for preaching.
Yes. So, and also the teacher said that the preaching is 30% about such knowledge. And 70% about human relationship. If this devotee will not make a vow to be a preacher, because this devotee, he will not go, he's not, she's not going to rent a house and to make to devote some money or some effort. So in that case, so the devotee's question is how to deal with this situation, or this how to deal with the devotee, because she want to learn the sutra, but she cannot make sure she will become a preacher in the future. She just want to learn the knowledge, but she cannot. She's not sure she will.
Okay. So we give everyone the chance to learn the knowledge. Everyone should be given an opportunity to study, even though they may not be preaching, they may not be active preachers now, or they may not be in the future, but still they should be given the opportunity to study.
我们应该给予每个人学习经典的机会，即便他不去传教，不管他是现在还是将来是否去传教，我们都应该给他机会学习经典知识。
Somebody has a desire to hear and to take part and sit and listen to classes, we should encourage them.
有的人他有学习的愿望，很想聆听，我们就要鼓励他。
We know they may not be preachers, but still we give everyone the chance to come and hear and study.
他们即便将来不能当传，就是去传播的人，我们也要邀请他们来聆听。
We're trying to engage everyone, Krishna consciousness.
我们是努力的让每一个人都从事都有 Krishna 之觉。
Of course, some devotee may talk like that to try to induce that person to preach.
有的人他可能是这样说，就是为了来引导别人将来去传播。
OK, 下一个问题。
好的，下一个问题 ，Chaitanya Charan Prabhu, Dear Guruji, 奉献者无论在天堂还是地狱，只要服务 Krishna 就满足了。那我们是不是，不用回到灵性世界了呢？这次冠状病毒，我发现物质世界太可怕了，我还是想早点回灵性世界比较好。
OK.So, the question is, if we can serve Krishna in heaven or hell, so why do we need spiritual world? We can just serve Krishna here. We don't need to go to the spiritual world, right?
Yes, but due to this coronavirus situation, I found it's very horrible. So I still want to go back to the spiritual world.
Mm-hmm. Okay.So Krishna is inviting, wants us to come back. We should, you know, but at the same time, we're dependent on Krishna. Whatever Krishna wants, we do. What we want is devotional service. That's the main mood of the devotee. Birth after birth. Birth after birth, we just want service.
主 Krishna 邀请每一个灵魂回到灵性世界，同时我们是依赖主 Krishna 来做他希望我们做的事情，我们的心态是生生世世的做奉爱服务、奉献服务，无论 Krishna 让我们做什么，我们就做什么。
Yeah, but at the same time, you know there are many horrible things here, as you said. There's horrible diseases, nasty things here in the material world. It's not a pleasant place.
同时呢，就像您说的，这里呢有那么多可怕的事情，有那么多肮脏的事情，一个很好的地方。
But a devotee will tolerate all these difficulties for service to Krishna.
奉献者为了服务 Krishna 会容忍这一切。
下一个问题，请问世界都是灵魂，那么在灵性世界。吃的这个菩萨的这个原料也都是灵魂吗？这个能吃吗？然后我们吃的这个中草药是不是也需要供奉净化后再吃
？Yes, when we eat some Chinese medicine, herb medicine, should we offer it? Yes, you should offer it.
是的，中草药也要供奉。
You can just simply say Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, if you want.
如果你愿意的话，你可以简单的就是念三遍 Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu.
Mm-hmm. Was that the only, was there a question in the beginning or?
In the beginning, the question is that since in the spiritual world everything is spiritual and.Or the element is spirit.、
Yeah.
So food is also made from the element of spirit.、
Oh. Yeah, yes. Right.
是的
Krishna's elements. While we say prasadam is spiritual, it's Krishna's.It's Krishna's, we're taking Krishna's mercy.
We say prasadam is Krishna's mercy.
Krishna gives us this food to eat, to purify our existence.
Krishna gives us this food to eat, to purify our existence.
OK, 下一个问题。
Good day. 我们就这些问题了 ，That's all.
OK, so we'll stop here. It's already late. OK, thank you very much, Guru Mani. Thank you, Sati. Have a good day. Hare Krishna.